It's Mike with Tech PB, and I haven't seen any literature out there on the new 2009 Shocker board on some of my favorite websites like Shocker Owners or ZDSPB.com. And I've had a couple questions come in of some people that have purchased the new 2009 Shocker, and the board manuals aren't out yet on the new modes. So I got one of those boards, I tested it out, kind of got an idea of what the modes, what the adjustments are and stuff like that. So I'm going to try to put a video out there really quick as we wait on Smart Parts to come up with the manual for the 2009 Shocker board. So you guys know, in 2009, the new Shockers, if you purchase them directly from Smart Parts, they're coming with the matching Q-Lock feed neck, and they're also coming with a new board with new programming that has got basically all the modes. So what I'm going to do really quick is I'm going to take you through the modes of the 2009 Shocker board, hopefully get you by for right now until Smart Parts comes out with the actual manual for it. Okay, there is basically, you still have the basic three adjustments. You have the modes, you have the recharge, and you have the dwell. Okay, dwell, obviously you have two buttons on the Shocker board, up and down. I usually set all my Shockers at 36 chirps, which is 12 milliseconds of dwell, and the gun shoot really, really well. So, you know, obviously there's ways you can fine tune that. It's your gun, do whatever you want, but if you set it at 12 milliseconds of dwell, your gun should shoot pretty good. The next thing we're going to talk about is the modes, the five new modes that come on the Shocker boards. You guys remember for years, the only thing you had was rebound, okay, which is just a fancy word for just ramping. Now you actually have real modes in the guns. The guns come with the semi-auto, they come with the PSP 3 shot with the 1 second timeout, they come with the Millennium mode, they also come with the NXL full auto, and also ramping mode, or like PSP ramping mode. So I'm going to show you guys really quickly how to adjust your modes. First thing we'll do is we'll just turn the gun on. Now, how you adjust the modes is you hit the power button, and we're going to start off at semi-auto, which is mode one. So we're going to hold the power button, go all the way down. And that should be semi-auto. Let's see. Okay. So that is semi-auto. So that is the first mode that you have. Now, how the modes work, it's like a sequential gear shift, okay? It goes mode 1, mode 2, mode 3, mode 4, mode 5. Now what we're going to do is we're going to put the mode in the second mode, which is PSP 3 shot with the 1 second timeout. So we're going to hold the power button and go up a chirp. So this should be PSP 3 shot with 1 second timeout. Now, I believe right now I have it on uncapped. We're going to get to that here in a second. There you go. PSP 3 shot with a 1 second timeout. The next is the Millennium mode. How the Millennium mode works is you have to pull the trigger to 8 balls per second. And once you get to 8 balls per second, the gun will ramp to whatever your cap is. In this case, it's pretty much uncapped, which are probably 17, 18 balls per second. But let's go ahead and go to the Millennium mode. So what I'm going to do is now we're in mode 2. We're going to go up to mode 3. We hold the power button, hit the up button once. And now we should be in Millennium. Now, it's not going to ramp as easy this time. I'm going to have to shoot the gun a little bit faster to get to that 8 balls per second for the gun to start ramping. So you can see. See, it's not ramping because we got to pull it at 8 balls per second. So let's use two fingers. Okay, so that is NXL. The next mode that they have in line is Millennium. The next mode that they have is NXL. NXL is basically 1, 2, 3 pulls. Fourth pull, you can hold it down and it goes into full auto. So let's go ahead and hit the power button. So we hold the power button, hit the up. Okay. Turn the eyes back on, and now we are on NXL full auto. So you go 1, 2, 3, hold the button, hold the trigger down, and it should be full auto. Okay, so that's NXL full auto. Next mode that's on there, which is mode 5, which is the last mode on the new 2009 Shocker board, is the PSP ramp. Now, PSP ramp is a little different than PSP 3 shot. PSP 3 shot gives you 1 second 1 second of time to pull the trigger again for three shots. PSP ramp, you have to pull at least 5 balls per second for the gun to ramp. So you have to, if you drop below 5 balls per second, the gun doesn't ramp. It doesn't give you a timeout. It has to be 5 balls per second and above for the gun to ramp. So let's go into the last mode, which is PSP ramping. So we hit the power button. And now you hear the chirp because what I did was I hit it twice, so we hit 5. I tried to go higher than that. It chirped, tell me, nope, 5 is the last mode. This is PSP ramping, and turn the eyes back on. This is PSP ramping, and basically you're going to see that as I pull the trigger, you have to hit 5 balls per second for the gun to ramp. So we try. But it doesn't give that 1 second timeout like the PSP 3 shot. So you got to get to pretty much 5 balls per second for the gun to ramp. Okay, now the next thing is the recharge. What is recharge? Recharge is basically is delaying the cycle of the bolt to slow the gun down. Recharge, what you do is as you add recharge, it slows down your rate of fire. So recharge is basically that time after the gun fires that the gun is going to delay before it fires again. Now, I'm taking a look at it for the diehard shocker owners. You remember the recharge before went in 1 second increments. The new 2009 board has 22 adjustments, and I believe each chirp is 5 milliseconds of recharge. So if you want true 10 balls per second, what you have to set it at is 18 chirps from the bottom. And with 18 chirps from the bottom, what that's going to do is that gives you, what is that, 90... Yeah, that gives you 90 milliseconds of recharge plus 12 milliseconds for the dwell, puts you at 102 milliseconds, which puts you just under the 10 ball per second, makes it basically 10 ball per second legal. So let's go ahead and do recharge. Now, recharge you got to be a little careful about because you have to hit the trigger, and then you have to hit the trigger, then hit the dwell up and down in order to go into recharge. So what we're going to do is we're going to go 18 chirps from the bottom, and we should be at about 10 balls per second. So let's hold the trigger down. Let's go 18 chirps from the bottom. Okay, so we're 18 chirps from the bottom. Now what we're going to do is now we're already in PSP ramping, so we should be at about 10 balls per second, PSP ramping, and this should be the legal mode for PSP going into 2009. So let's see if this slows this gun down to about 10 balls per second. That is about 10 balls per second. So I'm pretty sure that I've got the modes down right. I'm pretty sure I've got the recharge down right. Go to techvb.com, go into the smart parts, go into the markers. I'm going to do a quick, just a little Word document that you guys can download free of charge until smart parts gets the manual.